In Greek and Roman mythology, Castor and Pollux or Polyjuices were twin brothers, together known as the Dioscuri. Their mother was Leda, but Castor was the mortal son of Tyndareus, the king of Sparta, and Pollux the divine son of Zeus, who raped Leda in the guise of a swan. Though accounts of their birth have varied, they are sometimes said to have been born from an egg, along with their twin sisters and half-sisters Helen of Troy and Clytemnestra. In Latin, the twins are also known as the Gemini or Castors. When Castor was killed, Pollux asked Zeus to let him share his own immortality with his twin to keep them together, and they were transformed into the constellation Gemini. The pair were regarded as the patrons of sailors, to whom they appeared as Saint Elmo's fire, and were also associated with horsemanship. They are sometimes called the Tyndaridae or Tyndarids, later seen as a reference to their father and stepfather Tyndareus. Birth and functions. The best-known story of the twins' birth is that Zeus disguised himself as a swan and seduced Leda. Thus Leda's children are frequently said to have hatched from two eggs that she then produced. The Dioscuri can be recognized in vase paintings by the skull cap they wear, the pilus, which was explained in antiquity as the remnants of the egg. Whether the children are thus mortal or half-immortal is not consistent among the accounts, nor is whether the twins hatched together from one egg. In some accounts, only Pollux was fathered by Zeus, while Leda and her husband Tyndareus conceived Castor. This explains why they were granted an alternate immortality. It is a common belief that one would live among the gods, while the other was among the dead. The figure of Tyndareus may have entered their tradition to explain their archaic name Tyndaridae in Spartan inscriptions or in literature. Tyndaridae, in turn, occasioning incompatible accounts of their parentage. Castor and Pollux are sometimes both mortal, sometimes both divine. One consistent point is that if only one of them is immortal, it is Pollux. In Homer's Iliad, Helen looks down from the walls of Troy and wonders why she does not see her brothers among the Achaeans. The narrator remarks that they are both already dead and buried back in their homeland of Laestymon, thus suggesting that at least in some early traditions, both were mortal. Their death and shared immortality offered by Zeus was material of the lost Cypria in the epic cycle. The Dioscuri were regarded as helpers of humankind and held to be patrons of travelers and of sailors in particular, who invoked them to seek favorable winds. Their role as horsemen and boxers also led to them being regarded as the patrons of athletes and athletic contests. They characteristically intervened at the moment of crisis, aiding those who honored or trusted them. Mythology. Both Dioscuri were excellent horsemen and hunters who participated in the hunting of the Calydonian boar and later joined the crew of Jason's ship, the Argo. As Argonauts during the expedition of the Argonauts, Pollux took part in a boxing contest and defeated King Amycus of the Bebrises, a savage mythical people in Bithynia. After returning from the voyage, the Dioscuri helped Jason and Peleus to destroy the city of Iolcus in revenge for the treachery of its king Peleus, rescuing Helen when their sister and half-sister Helen was abducted by Theseus. The half-brothers invaded his kingdom of Attica to rescue her. In revenge, they abducted Theseus's mother Aethra and took her to Sparta while setting his rival, Menestheus, on the throne of Athens. Aethra was then forced to become Helen's slave. She was ultimately returned to her home by her grandsons Demophon and Acamas after the fall of Troy. The Leucippides, Lynceus and Death, Castor and Pollux aspired to marry the Leucippides, Phoebe and Hilaera, whose father was a brother of Leucippus. Both women were already betrothed to cousins of the Dioscuri, the twin brothers Lynceus and Idas of Thebes, sons of Tyndareus's brother Aphareus. Castor and Pollux carried the women off to Sparta, wherein each had a son. Phoebe bore Nesiolios to Pollux and Hilaera bore Anogon to Castor. This began a family feud among the four sons of the brothers Tyndareus and Aphareus. The cousins carried out a cattle raid in Arcadia together, but fell out over the division of the meat. After stealing the herd, but before dividing it, the cousins butchered, quartered, and roasted a calf. As they prepared to eat, the gigantic Idas suggested that the herd be divided into two parts instead of four, based on which pair of cousins finished their meal first. Castor and Pollux agreed. Idas quickly ate both his portion and Lynceus a portion. Castor and Pollux had been duped. They allowed their cousins to take the entire herd, but vowed to someday take revenge. Sometime later, Idas and Lynceus visited their uncle's home in Sparta. The uncle was on his way to Crete, so he left Helen in charge of entertaining the guests, which included both sets of cousins, as well as Paris, Prince of Troy. Castor and Pollux recognized the opportunity to exact revenge, made an excuse that justified leaving the feast, and set out to steal their cousins' herd. Idas and Lynceus eventually set out for home, leaving Helen alone with Paris, who then kidnapped her. Thus, the four cousins helped set into motion the events that gave rise to the Trojan War. Meanwhile, Castor and Pollux had reached their destination. Castor climbed a tree to keep a watch as Pollux began to free the cattle. Far away, Idas and Lynceus approached. Lynceus, named for the lynx because he could see in the dark, spied Castor hiding in the tree. Idas and Lynceus immediately understood what was happening. Idas, furious, ambushed Castor, fatally wounding him with a blow from his spear, but not before Castor called out to warn Pollux. In the ensuing brawl, Pollux killed Lynceus. As Idas was about to kill Pollux, Zeus, who had been watching from Mount Olympus, hurled a thunderbolt, killing Idas and saving his son. Returning to the dying Castor, Pollux was given the choice by Zeus of spending all his time on Mount Olympus or giving half his immortality to his mortal brother. He opted for the latter, enabling the twins to alternate between Olympus and Hades. The brothers became the two brightest stars in the constellation Gemini, Castor and Pollux. As emblems of immortality and death, the Dioscuri, like Heracles, were said to have been initiated into the Eleusinian mysteries. Iconography. Castor and Pollux are consistently associated with horses in art and literature. They are widely depicted as helmeted horsemen carrying spears. The Pseudo-Oppian manuscript depicts the brothers hunting, both on horseback and on foot. On votive reliefs they are depicted with a variety of symbols representing the concept of twinhood, such as the docanar, a pair of amphorae, a pair of shields, or a pair of snakes. They are also often shown wearing felt caps, sometimes with stars above. They are depicted on metopes from Delphi showing them on the voyage of the Argo and rustling cattle with Idas. Greek vases regularly show them in the rape of the Leucippides, as Argonauts. In religious ceremonies and at the delivery to leader of the egg containing Helen, they can be recognized in some vase paintings by the skull cap they wear, the pilus, which was already explained in antiquity as the remnants of the egg from which they hatched. Shrines and rites. The Dioscuri were worshipped by the Greeks and Romans alike. There were temples to the twins in Athens, such as the Arnakian, and Rome, as well as shrines in many other locations in the ancient world. The Dioscuri and their sisters grew up in Sparta, in the royal household of Tyndareus. They were particularly important to the Spartans, who associated them with the Spartan tradition of dual kingship and appreciated that two princes of their ruling house were elevated to immortality. Their connection there was very ancient. A uniquely Spartan and iconic representation of the Tyndaridae was as two upright posts joined by a crossbar, as the protectors of the Spartan army. The beam figure, or docanar, was carried in front of the army on campaign. Sparta's unique dual kingship reflects the divine influence of the Dioscuri. When the Spartan army marched to war, one king remained behind at home, accompanied by one of the twins. In this way, the real political order is secured in the realm of the gods. Their Heroon or grave shrine was on a mountaintop at Therapna across the Eurotas from Sparta, at a shrine known as the Menelaia, where Helen, Menelaus, Castor and Pollux were all said to be buried. Castor himself was also venerated in the region of Castoria in northern Greece. They were commemorated both as gods on Olympus worthy of Holocaust, and as deceased mortals in Hades, whose spirits had to be propitiated by libations. Lesser shrines to Castor, Pollux and Helen were also established at a number of other locations around Sparta. The pear tree was regarded by the Spartans as sacred to Castor and Pollux, and images of the twins were hung in its branches. The standard Spartan oath was to swear by the two gods. The rite Theoxenia, god entertaining, was particularly associated with Castor and Pollux. The two deities were summoned to a table laid with food, whether at individuals' own homes or in the public hearths or equivalent places controlled by states. They are sometimes shown arriving at Hevgallop over a food-laden table. Although such table offerings were a fairly common feature of Greek cult rituals, they were normally made in the shrines of the gods or heroes concerned. The domestic setting of the Theoxenia was a characteristic distinction accorded to the Dioscuri. The image of the twins attending a goddess are widespread and linked the Dioscuri with the male societies of initiates under the aegis of the Anatolian great goddess and the great gods of Samothrace. The Dioscuri are the inventors of war dances, which characterize the Kurites. Indo-European analogues. The heavenly twins appear also in the Indo-European tradition as the effulgent Vedic brother horsemen the Ashvans, the Lithuanian Asvianirai, and the Germanic Alcis. Italy and the Roman Empire. From the 5th century BC onwards, the brothers were revered by the Romans, probably as the result of cultural transmission via the Greek colonies of Magna Graecia in southern Italy. An archaic Latin inscription of the 6th or 5th century BC found at Lavinium, which reads Castor apod Lycae qua, suggests a direct transmission from the Greeks. The word qua is virtually a transliteration of the Greek word kappa omicron epsilon rho omicron iota sigma, while pod Lycae is effectively a transliteration of the Greek pi omicron lambda epsilon delta epsilon epsilon kappa eta sigma. The construction of the Temple of Castor and Pollux, located in the Roman Forum at the heart of their city, was undertaken to fulfill a vow made by Aulus Postumius Albus Regillensis in gratitude at the Roman victory in the Battle of Lake Regillus in 495 BC. The establishing of the temple may also be a form of evocatio, the transferal of a tutelary deity from a defeated town to Rome, where cult would be offered in exchange for favor. According to legend, the twins fought at the head of the Roman army and subsequently brought news of the victory back to Rome. The Locrians of Magna Graecia had attributed their success at a legendary battle on the banks of the Sagra to the intervention of the twins. The Roman legend may in fact have had its origins in the Locrian account and possibly supplies further evidence of cultural transmission between Rome and Magna Graecia. The Romans believed that the twins aided them on the battlefield. Their role as horsemen made them particularly attractive to the Roman equites and cavalry. Each year on July 15, the feast day of the Dioscuri, the 1,800 equestrians would parade through the streets of Rome in an elaborate spectacle in which each rider wore full military attire and whatever decorations he had earned. In translations of comedies by Plautus, women generally swear by Castor, and men by Pollux. This is exemplified by the slave woman character Staphyla in A Pot of Gold, where she swears by Castor in line 67. Then the negative prefix in line 71 denotes a refutation against swearing by Pollux. Etruscan Castor and Pultus. The Etruscans venerated the twins as Castor and Pultus, collectively the Tinas Cliniares, sons of Tinia, the Etruscan counterpart of Zeus. They were often portrayed on Etruscan mirrors, as was the fashion in Greece. They could also be portrayed symbolically. One example can be seen in the Tomba dell'Età Funebre at Tarquinia, where Alectastinium for them is painted. They are symbolized in the painting by the presence of two pointed caps crowned with laurel, referring to the Phrygian caps they were often depicted wearing. Christianization. Even after the rise of Christianity, the Dioscuri continued to be venerated. The 5th century Pope Gelasius I attested to the presence of a cult of Castors that the people did not want to abandon. In some instances, the twins appear to have simply been absorbed into a Christian framework. Thus, 4th century AD pottery and carvings from North Africa depict the Dioscuri alongside the 12 apostles, the raising of Lazarus, or with Saint Peter. The church took an ambivalent attitude, rejecting the immortality of the Dioscuri but seeking to replace them with equivalent Christian pairs. Saints Peter and Paul were thus adopted in place of the Dioscuri as patrons of travelers, and Saints Cosmas and Damian took over their function as healers. Some have also associated Saints Speusippus, Elisippus, and Melapsippus with the Dioscuri. The New Testament scholar Dennis MacDonald identifies Castor and Pollux as basis characters for the appearance of James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, who appear in the narrative by Mark the Evangelist. MacDonald cites the origin of this identification to 1913, when J. Rendell Harris published his work Boanerges, a Greek term for thunder, the epithet of Zeus, father of Pollux, in what MacDonald calls a form of early Christian Dioscurism.